Hey man, how's it going? Do you ever privately wonder to yourself if some of your major life decisions are just really dumbass decisions? Like, man, I think I'm making some really stupid decisions that I'm going to regret later on in life. If you're watching this and you feel that in the pit of your stomach right now in some area of your life, please keep watching. That area of your life could be getting married, breaking up, a decision like moving to a different state, changing jobs, changing careers, breaking up with somebody, anything major in your life, buying a home, building a home. The reason why is for the past 11 years, I've been helping men end their out-of-control behaviors, their addictive behaviors with porn, sex, and masturbation. And one thing a lot of men have in common, especially later on in life, in their 30s and in their 40s and beyond, is I meet a lot of men who made decisions at a certain point in life, and those decisions, they seemed like the right decision. And over the years, they justified it and they rationalized it over and over again. And now they are deeply unhappy because they have been saddled with responsibilities they never wanted. Society, their church, their family, their culture told them that they should do that. This is what makes you a man. But deep down inside, they didn't want to. You did not want to get married. But pressure from your family in your late 20s made you do it. Now you're stepping out on your wife every opportunity that you get. You're viewing pornography because you did not have enough sexual experiences. You got married because it was the right thing to do. Peer pressure, all your friends inviting you to weddings, parents saying, when are you gonna give me a grandchild? You did that. Now you're seeking my help because you are severely addicted to pornography. You are unhappy. Married this girl, but she's fucking crazy. You didn't go out there and improve your dating skills. You just got with this girl because she was the most pretty girl with the most decent personality. But you did not screen her for anything else. For values, for what else she wanted in life. Nothing. Nothing at all. Just the most superficial thing. And then you rode that new relationship energy, that NRE, all the way to the altar. Now she doesn't even like you. She doesn't even want to be intimate with you. So you view pornography, you go to the strip club, you hire escorts, and you're funding some girl's OnlyFans, some girl's tuition via her OnlyFans, right? You hadn't gotten your shit together financially, and then everybody put pressure on you. You're a grown man. Buy a house. Bro, you just got a job. You haven't even saved six figures. Shit, forget that. You haven't even saved five figures in the bank. And you're ready to buy a house. Oh yes, it's the best investments that you can get. Whatever the decision is, all right? Even if it's we got married and you know what? The next thing is to buy a house and have kids. There is nothing wrong with these things. And I know that many of you watching this have absolutely crushed it. But this is for you. If you're making that decision right now and you are not ready, some of you guys are not ready to be in a marriage. You're not ready for that, but you don't want to admit it to yourself, right? Some of you are not ready to be purchasing a home. Some of you are not ready to be starting your own business. Oh, I want to start my own business, but you haven't demonstrated any level of discipline working for somebody else. Check out early. Your loving memes on Instagram about laziness culture, about oh, the workforce and how employers use us and how we hate Zoom meetings and waking up early. You want to work the remote lifestyle. You want to be a freelancer. You want to run your own business, but you have no self-discipline. Do you understand that you have to be the absolute hardest taskmaster? You have to be the best manager of yourself and your time and your resources in order to run your own business successfully? Do you get that? Some of you are not ready for that. And if you're making those decisions right now, I urge you to not just listen to your family and your friends, but to actually sit down, put pen to paper, and brother, listen to yourself. This is not about bringing up your self-doubt and engaging it. This is about being rational. Here's what you should do. Find the must. MUST, the masturbatory thought, so to speak. Oftentimes, when you're making one of these horrible life decisions that you will come to regret because you're not ready, there is a must statement in there. I must get married before the age of whatever, because if I don't, something horrible will happen to me. But you don't know what that thing is. You've never actually verbalized it, and even if you have, you haven't really examined it. Chances are, whatever it is, I must run my own business, I must change my job, I must have kids, I must do all these things. Chances are it is attached to some sort of mass conditioning that you did not examine. It's not about your happiness. It's because it's the right thing to do. If the reason you are doing this is because, number one, it feels right, and number two, when you talk to other people, they tell you it's the right thing to do. They are the ones who are telling you there is no right time to get married. There's no right time to have kids. Notice the only people telling you this shit are people who have already made that decision, and you will never truly know how they came to make that decision. Conditioning. You know how when somebody says, hey, you're dating someone, right? And you say, we're gonna get married, right? Nobody says, y'all ain't fucking ready for that. Y'all just started your career. Shit, he doesn't have a job. Why y'all getting married? No, everybody says, oh my God, we're so happy for you. This shit's going to figure itself out, right? Like, when's the wedding? But when you've been dating someone for a while and you say, we're not gonna get married, people look at you and go like, well, what's wrong with y'all? Are you okay? Like, why are you, what's happening, right? Conditioning. People are conditioned to act a certain way. And many of you are making decisions based on that. Find the must. If you don't, you might end up making a decision because it feels right, because that's the templates that was given to you, because you haven't spent enough time going within and exploring what you want and establishing your values and your standards based on principles that you have examined as well, timeless principles, and you're going to end up medicating your pain with something. In the case of many of my clients, it's sexual behavior. Most of them are men. But for others, it's much worse. Some people are medicating with abusing their spouses, abusing their children. Some people become so bitter because of the burden that is on them, that they become horrible parents, inflicting trauma on their children through verbal, physical, and mental abuse, all because you are not happy, because you did these things that had musts attached to them and you never examined them. So this is a little bit of a rant, right? To be honest with y'all, and I'm gonna end it right now. I always hear this, but it gets very frustrating when, for the length of time I've been doing this, I'll speak to somebody and I'm like, hey man, I don't think you should get married yet. Like, why? Well, I think you should control your behavior with pornography, right? I don't think you should be purchasing a home right now. This is my recommendation as a coach. I can't tell people what to do. None of us can do that. We can't control people, rather. We can only influence them, right? Why is the right thing to do? Well, you also mentioned there are many other things that you want to do in life. You've lived in the same place for a long time. You've worked so hard to save up money. You don't know much about real estate. The only reason you're doing this is because your parents said it's the right thing to do. And everywhere, when you've spoken to people and told them like, hey, I'm thinking of purchasing my first home, everybody encourages you. Just like everyone says like, wow, it's wonderful that you guys are getting married. Oh, you're purchasing your first home? Congratulations, we are assuming that you are a responsible individual. But the divorce rate is, that's just the people who are actually getting divorced, not the ones who are staying together unhappily. There are so many people who are saddled to a mortgage for the rest of their life and have predatory real estate professionals circling them all the time, suffering because they made that decision to tie themselves to a home when they were not ready. Oh, it was the market. No. You made a decision to purchase a home knowing it was a long-term investment, but you didn't take the responsibility to understand what it could mean in different economic cycles. Oh, that's too much? It's too much because you are not thinking. And it's frustrating to see people make this mistake over and over again. If you're listening to this, you're making a major decision in your life, please take a moment, pause, ask yourself what your values are, what your standards are, what the must is. And listen, if you're scared, if you're like, bro, I'm really afraid, like what you're saying is making sense, shoot me a DM, send me a message, or email me. I'll talk to you about it. I'm not going to convince you to do anything. No one can control you, but I can give you some statistics. I can give you examples. I can give you alternatives for you to think about. And I also can give you resources. I'm not the only one who thinks this way, right? My life is far from perfect, but I'm happy. I'm fulfilled. I'm excited in the things I do. And I suffer like everyone else. I also make terrible decisions. But thankfully, I'm yet to make one terrible decision that I would regret for years and years to come. And I'm a grown-ass man pushing 40, all right? So I think that says a lot, okay? Maybe it doesn't. Who cares? All right, I'm done. I appreciate y'all watching. Comment and let me know your thoughts.